Let's discuss the situation of oblique collision of a ball on a flat surface. And we can see we are having a smooth surface on which a ball strikes at an angle of incidence theta. At the time of collision, deformation between ball and floor will take place and the contact force will act in a direction normal to the surface, which can be taken as line of impact. And say after collision, ball rebounds with a speed v at an angle phi. Now, in this type of oblique collision of a ball on a flat surface, we analyze three cases. Say we consider case 1 for an elastic collision. So, here we talk about elastic collision, we can take E is equals to 1. Coefficient of restitution here we can take as 1. Now, in this situation, if coefficient of restitution is 1, we can state that velocity of approach is equal to velocity of separation along the line of impact. So, here if we talk about the line of impact, we can state the approach velocity of the ball would be u cos theta and the separation velocity would be v cos phi if u and v are the initial and final velocities. So, here we can simply state u cos theta must be equals to v cos phi as the collision is elastic. Now, we can also observe one more thing that the floor is smooth. That means the horizontal component of velocity which is u sin theta, this velocity will not experience any force in horizontal direction. So, after collision, if it is v sin phi, that is the horizontal component of the final velocity of ball, this must be exactly equal to this because momentum in horizontal direction of the ball must remain constant as no external forces acting on ball. So, along with this equation, we can also write u sin theta is equals to v sin phi. Now, from these equations 1 and 2, we can see from 1 and 2, very easily we can see here that v must be equals to u and phi must be equals to theta. That means in case of elastic collision of a ball which will incident on a floor at some angle, it will rebound with the same angle of reflection and with the same velocity. Velocity can be considered equal as we know that in elastic collision, in case of elastic collision, no energy loss takes place at the time of deformation. So, final kinetic energy must be exactly equal to the initial kinetic energy, hence we can state a ball will rebound with the same speed. And with the logic of equation number 1, as approach and incident velocities, approach and separation velocities are equal, we can state that the angle of reflection must be equal to angle of incidence. So, here we can write angle of reflection must be equal to angle of incidence. So, be careful about the logic. Let's have a discussion on case 2. Now, let's analyze the case 2 of partial elastic collision in the similar situation. Again, say we consider the smooth floor. And in this situation, the ball is striking at an angle of incidence theta and reflecting at an angle phi. Here we can state that approach velocity of the ball along the line of impact will be u cos theta and separation velocity will be v cos phi. And we can see that in case of partial elastic collision, the coefficient of restitution is between 0 and 1. So, in this situation, we can write along line of impact, we can use v cos phi is equals to e times u cos theta because these are separation velocity which is equals to e times the approach velocity. So, we can state in this situation, one equation we are having is v cos phi is e times u cos theta, that will be say our equation 1. And along the surface, if we just have a look, along the surface initial velocity was u sin theta. And after collision, it was V sin phi. So, as the surface is smooth and no external force is present, we can write along the surface, the momentum will remain same. So, we can simply write as the single ball is there, mass is equal. Here we can write V sin phi is equals to U sin theta. That is our equation number 2. Now, if we just square the two equations and add, we can see root of 1 square plus 2 square, you can see, will be getting on left hand side, it will be cos square phi plus sin square phi, it will be 1. So, it is V is equals to, on right hand side, it is E square U square cos square theta plus U square sin square theta. So, here we can write U root of sin square theta plus E square cos square theta. This is the relation we are getting for final and initial velocity after and before collision for a ball on the flat surface. And here we can also find out the angle of reflection phi by dividing the two equations. Say if we execute 2 by 1, here you can see this V gets cancelled out and this will give us tan phi, which is equal to 1 by E tan theta. This is the relation between the angle of reflection and angle of incidence. You need to be careful about the two. And here if we just substitute E equals to 1, we can see for E equals to 1, this term within the sine of under root becomes 1 because it will be sine square theta plus cos square theta. So, we can write for E equals to 1, V is equals to U and here phi is equals to theta. That was the case 1 we already discussed in the previous slide. Let us see the third case of the similar situation when collision is perfectly inelastic. Here we know very well that an inelastic collision E is equal to 0 and the coefficient of restitution 0 implies no separation, or we can state separation velocity along line of impact should be equals to 0. So, if the ball is coming with a speed u at an angle of incidence theta on the flat surface, say if the surface is smooth, in this situation its approach velocity we can write as u cos theta and along the surface velocity component can be written as u sin theta. Now, in this situation when the ball strikes, as the collision is perfectly inelastic, whatever level of deformation occurs here, the deformation will not be recovered and will remain as it is. But due to smooth surface, as no external forces acting on the ball in horizontal direction, the ball continue to move forward with the speed u sin theta. So, here we can state it will not separate from the surface. It will slide along the surface as it is. This is the situation when a body incident at some angle strikes to a surface, and if both surface and bodies are made up of inelastic material, the body will not separate from the surface. That is a situation of an inelastic collision for a body striking obliquely on a flat surface.